Thank you for tuning in. You're watching the news on Mirror Now with me, Kavita Krishnan. We've got lots lined up for you on this bulletin, but first, the headlines.
पीछे से आके उसी बंदे ने ठोका। उसी एक्सीडेंट की वजह से मेरा दोस्त गुरप्रीत, जो कि बाइक चला रहा था, वो आज एक्सपायर हो गया। और मुझे उसके लिए इंसाफ चाहिए।
Out shooting a documentary on Delhi, young Gurpreet Singh gets mowed down by a drunk man's car in a fit of rage. The Delhi police let the accused walk out on bail, but slap additional charges under Section 302 against the accused. Their anticipatory bail plea gets adjourned again, but the Pintos are still free. The Haryana police defends itself, claims that summons were sent, but Ryan school owners have gone into hiding. In Bihar, a 40-year-long mega project collapses a day before inauguration. Huge embarrassment for the Nitish government. Almost 400 crore rupees wasted, with the Bagalpur embankment breaking. The SHE team, the women wing of the Telangana police, arrests a neta's son for allegedly harassing women on social media. Second straight day of heavy rainfall in Mumbai, parts of Thane severely waterlogged, schools and colleges shut, people stay off the roads, but only few waterlogging reports. The BMC chief is out on the roads monitoring the situation. Our big story this hour, it's a shocker from the national capital. A man was killed for objecting to smoking in public. Gurpreet Singh had asked a smoker to not smoke in public, but he ended up paying with his life for trying to enforce the law. The smoker followed Gurpreet and slammed his car into his bike. Gurpreet has succumbed to his injuries. What is shocking is the fact that the accused has been given bail. Also, Times Network has accessed pictures of Rohit Mahanta, the main accused in the case. We now learn that Mahanta was allegedly drunk at the time he ran over Gurpreet Singh's bike. The latest we are getting is that the additional charge of IPC Section 302 or culpable homicide has also been slapped against the accused Mahanta. Priyank now joins me with more on that case. Priyank, additional charge of 302 now slapped on Mahanta. How does this change the case?
See, there is a slight clarification. The Section 304 of Indian Penal Code has been added in the FIR, which is of culpable homicide not amounting to murder. And this has been added after the statement of the victim's friend, who was also on the bike, was recorded by the Delhi police officials. Initially, it was a case of negligent driving, which was registered by the Delhi police officials. But after the death of the victim and after the statement of the victim's friend, this fresh section of Indian Penal Code has been added in the FIR by the Delhi police officials. Back to you.
Right. Priyank, if you could take us, if you could bring our viewers up to speed and take us through the entire case. How exactly was Gurpreet Singh murdered? Right, we seem to have lost connection over there with Priyanka, but Gurpreet Singh, of course, was out on the streets of Delhi shooting a documentary, stopped at a roadside stall for tea, for parathas, and got into a quarrel with the accused, after which, when people intervened, Gurpreet Singh reportedly left the spot. Following this, of course, what we hear is that Mahanta, the accused, then followed him and hit his bike from the behind in a fit of rage. Let's listen into some more reactions that have come in on that horrific story.
On 17th September, very early morning at about 4:30, there was an incident of road traffic accident in front of the Safdarjung Hospital Ames Trauma Center, in which two motorcycle riders, Gurpreet and Maninder, aged about 21 and 22 years, they were injured and admitted in Ames Trauma Center. And one person who was driving a Ford Fiesta car by the name of Rohit Mahanto, 26, he was the offending vehicle. that his car also hit an auto rickshaw followed by a Ola cab. So because these two motorcycle riders were not in a condition, medical condition, to record their statement, so we took the statement of the Ola cab driver and registered a case under 279-337 IPC. And today, Maninder, one of these two injured boys who were admitted in the AIIMS trauma center, Maninder is a 22 years, he became fit for statement. We have recorded his statement, and on the basis of his statement, we will take very strict appropriate legal action.
हमारी रिपोर्ट हमारी एफआईआर दर्ज नहीं हुई, हालांकि हमारा बच्चा वेंटिलेटर पे था, तो पुलिस से हमें यही गिला शिकवा है, जब हमारा बच्चा वेंटिलेटर पे है तो हमारा भी तो कुछ देखना चाहिए, आना चाहिए, हमारे से बयान लेने चाहिए। वो बेल पर बाहर है, इसीलिए हमें परेशानी है। अभी एक एक्सीडेंट हुआ, मर्डर हुआ, वो बेल पर बाहर घूम रहा है, तो पुलिस का क्या रिश्ता उनके साथ में? बस एक ही रिश्ता है, पैसे का रिश्ता, जो वो पुगा रही है। बस मैं तो यही कहूँगा, मैं तो पुलिस अथॉरिटी से ये कहना चाहता हूँ, इन्वेस्टिगेशन करके इसको, इस केस को मर्डर केस में कन्वर्ट करके और उस आदमी को अरेस्ट करके उसको जेल में डाला जाए, ताकि और आदमी कोई ऐसा काम करने की हिम्मत ना करे।
एफआईआर में उसका नाम गलत है, एफआईआर और डीएल में, मुझे नहीं पता ओरिजिनल नाम क्या है, बट वो मैच नहीं करता। आई डोंट नो ये गेम है या पुलिस की क्लेरिकल मिस्टेक है या एक बड़ा वो है, वी डोंट नो अबाउट दिस, बट हमने अप्रोच किया कि उसको करेक्ट किया जाए, उसका एक्चुअल जो नेम है वो डाला जाए एज पर आइडेंटिटी जो है, सो दैट इज़ अंडर प्रोसेसिंग।
हम जैसे कि फोटोग्राफी स्टूडेंट्स हैं, तो हम एक डॉक्यूमेंट्री पे काम कर रहे थे, नाइट लाइफ ऑन फुटपाथ इन दिल्ली, और हम उसी के लिए एम्स के पास देखने आए थे जगह कि क्या हम यहाँ पे शूट कर सकते हैं। तो उसके बाद हम एक जगह परांठे खाने के लिए रुके, और वहीं रुकते टाइम हमने परांठे खाए, चाय पी, और कुछ ही देर में जब हम निकलने ही वाले थे, कोई एक अनजान आदमी हमारे पास आया और सिगरेट पीते हुए सिगरेट का धुआं हमारे मुंह पर मारने लगा। तो जब हमने उससे कहा कि प्लीज़ आप थोड़ा साइड पे होके पी लीजिए, हम ये पसंद नहीं करते, तो उसने इसी बात को लेकर हमें गालियां देना शुरू कर दिया। इसी बात को लेकर जब मामला ज़्यादा गड़बड़ हो रहा था, तो हमने सोचा हम वहाँ से निकल जाएँ, तो इसी बात पर हम वहाँ से निकल गए, और थोड़ी ही आगे जाते हमें पीछे से आके उसी बंदे ने ठोका। उसी एक्सीडेंट की वजह से मेरा दोस्त गुरप्रीत, जो कि बाइक चला रहा था, वो आज एक्सपायर हो गया, और मुझे उसके लिए इंसाफ चाहिए।
हमें सुबह 7 बजे फ़ोन चला गया था, मैं चंडीगढ़।
आप अभी क्या चाहते हैं क्या?
सर हम ये चाहते हैं गुरप्रीत और मनिंदर को इंसाफ दिया जाए, जो भी दोषी है उसको उसके अकॉर्डिंग सजा दी जाए, जो भी उसने इतना बड़ा गुनाह किया, इंटेंशनली, ये एक्सीडेंट नहीं है, ये सीधा सा इंटेंशनली किया हुआ एक तो मर्डर है, ये उसने पूरा मतलब कि सोच समझ के किया है।
And just to reiterate what we are just picking up on the story, like our reporter Priyank pointed out, is that Section 304 has also been slapped on the accused Mahanta, but this too is a non-bailable offence. Moving on now, incessant rains over the last 24 hours caused 5 boats to capsize off the coast of Ratnagiri in Maharashtra. The fishing boats had 29 workers on board in total when they sank. 27 people have been rescued, one person has been declared dead, and one other is still missing. On your screen, of course, is a footage of that rescue which was carried out by the Coast Guard off the Ratnagiri coast. 5 fishing boats out at sea, 29 people on board in those boats, and 27 of these 29 people were rescued in a daring operation by the Coast Guard. Of course, with incessant rains, the seas have also been stormy, as you can see from the footage on your screens over there. 27, remember, there are 29 people on board those 5 boats, all fishing boats. 27 of these people were rescued by the Coast Guard. One person has been declared dead. One other person is still missing. We have Herman now, who's getting us more details on that. Herman, tell us more about this rescue operation. When was the alarm sounded? How long did the rescue operation last?
Well, what we are told is that this rescue operation did take off the Ratnagiri coast. If one is aware, definitely that is the area where it is a major port, and at the same time, there are a number of large fishing vessels also that are always into activity around the Ratnagiri coast. A total of 29 people is what we are told were present in the boat, out of which 27 people were rescued during that turbulent weather. And out of those 29, one has been confirmed dead. Therefore, there has been a casualty. That has been one person who's dead. And the search and rescue operation, meanwhile, still continue even as we speak at this point in time, that one has been still missing. So out of the total 29, 27 people have been rescued. Unfortunately, one has been the casualty. And still, meanwhile, search and rescue operation, despite the turbulent weather in the area, one person is still missing off the Ratnagiri coast.
Right. Herman, take us through the details of this entire rescue operation. We can see that the seas are very stormy over there. Obviously, it is a very, very tough rescue operation that the Coast Guard has pulled off, where they have managed to save 27 out of 29 people.
Well, that's right. You know, this is in fact the second fishing vessel that has been rescued by the Coast Guard. Remember, the first one was in fact of 14 people who were on board. All of those 14 people, in fact, were rescued by the Coast Guard. That was the first fishing vessel. In fact, in that vessel had been stranded for the last 10 days. That is when a distress call was received by the Indian Coast Guard, and that is when it had gone out to rescue those people. Out of all those 14 people who were in the first vessel, in fact, have been rescued. And meanwhile, on the second vessel that we are talking right now about, there were 29 people. That was also a distress call that was answered by the Indian Coast Guard. In fact, 29 people were on board in the first vessel. There were 14 in the second one, and all of those 14 were rescued safely. In the second one, there were 29 people on board. 27 out of those 29 have been rescued. One, unfortunately, has been the casualty. That has been one person who's been confirmed dead. And despite the weather, despite what IMD has been stating for the last 36 hours that we've been seeing, the rough weather as well as the turbulent rains in the area of the Ratnagiri coast, one continues to be missing. And therefore, in that direction, search and rescue operations continue by the Indian Coast Guard.
Right, Herman, thank you for getting us those details. Up next, a story of the moral police in action in Yogi's Uttar Pradesh. A Hindu girl and a Muslim boy sitting together in a snack shop in Aligarh were assaulted by the Hindu Jagran Manch and BJP workers because they were having an inter-religion affair. The president of the BJP women's wing for Aligarh, Sangeeta Varshney, even went a step ahead and slapped the girl allegedly. And I quote, "This is for going against her culture." As you can see from that footage on your screen over there, the BJP leaders sitting beside the girl, talking to her, giving her advice and slapping her. This was apparently because the girl went against her culture by having an affair, an inter-religion affair with a Muslim boy. The Hindu Jagran Manch and the BJP workers also confirmed that they were keeping an eye on this couple, as they frequently visited the snack shop and sat there for hours together. So that's what our leaders are busy with, keeping an eye on young people going out, hanging out in snack shops, and then giving them lectures on how they should be behaving in public. That is footage of the BJP MP slapping that girl because she went against her culture. Meanwhile, strict action must be taken against lovebirds spotted in public parks, on bikes and cars, as it is these people who cause rapes, says the BJP MP Sakshi Maharaj. Now, the BJP MP further went on to say that it is because of these couples that the media blames the government and the police and that they must be held responsible at all cost. Now, Sakshi Maharaj made this comment on his visit to Bharatpur in Rajasthan.
Motorcycle. कार हो, पार्क हो या कोई अन्य स्थल हो, वहाँ लड़के लड़कियाँ अश्लील हरकतें करते हुए पाए जाते हैं। मोटरसाइकिल पर इस प्रकार से आलिंगन करते हुए चलते हैं, जैसे लड़का लड़की को खा जाएगा या लड़की लड़के को खा जाएगी। कोई चर्चा नहीं करता, कोई एक्शन नहीं होता, कोई कार्रवाई नहीं होती, लेकिन जब बलात्कार हो जाता है तब पुलिस की वर्दी उतरती है, तब मीडिया वाले हुक्का लेकर के दौड़ते हैं क्या हो गया। तो मेरा मानना यह है कि ये जो हरकतें हो रही हैं सड़क पर चलते हुए, पार्कों में, जहाँ कहीं हो रही हैं, आगे कोई बड़ी घटना हो ना हो, इसलिए इस पर कार्रवाई होनी चाहिए। अगर किसी की कोई बहन है तो वो गलत हरकत नहीं कर सकता, अगर किसी की पत्नी है तो उसका घर होगा, अगर कोई कर रहा है, इट मीन्स ये दोनों गलत हैं, उनको पकड़ के बंद करनी चाहिए थाना।
Arvind joins me on the phone line now with more on this. Arvind, Bharatpur, of course, famous for its bird sanctuary, but obviously Sakshi Maharaj had much more on his mind. What prompted this remark about penalizing lovebirds?
Look, you heard the Sakshi Maharaj there. He is the motor mouth member of parliament of BJP, and whenever he speaks, he spews just controversies, controversies and controversies. And here what he has done in Bharatpur is that he is preaching that public display of affection leads to the law and order situation, and he is preaching the young society in India that what to do and what to not to do. This is our public representative revealing their archaic mindset here, that what they want to make India here. The problem here is that the political class in India is trying to control somehow the mind of youth, and they are equating the law and order situation in the society and in the country, which they have not been able to manage, to the various reasons of the failure. So it is clearly that he is passing the buck of the law and order situation failure, and even the incident like rape happening in our society, to this public display of affection. So it is clearly the archaic mindset of public representative which Sakshi Maharaj is clearly representing here. Back to you.
Right, Arvind, thank you for getting us those details. Maxim City, Mumbai, has been lashed by rains over the last 30 hours or so. But the Mumbai civic body, the BMC, the railways and the city's traffic police kept the city on move this Wednesday. At least 75 flights were cancelled at Mumbai airport due to heavy rains. Over September 19 and 20, in fact, Mumbai was pounded by 334 millimeter of rain. But the drains worked, there was little waterlogging and lesser traffic snarls reported. Now this, remember, despite Mumbai receiving more rainfall than it received on August 29th, when 303 millimeters of rain had brought the city to a grinding halt.
September, Mumbai received more rainfall than it did on the 29th of August, but surprisingly, the city is not inundated. The reason being, the civic authorities are on high alert and close to 150 pumping stations are currently working in the city to drain the water out. Not just that, even BMC Chief Ajoy Mehta was on the ground inspecting all these water pumps. He visited some of the historically low-lying areas, those areas which historically get inundated whenever Mumbai receives a lot of rainfall. Those areas have not got any kind of flooding at this point of time. So there are some pockets, SV Road near Bandra and Kurla and areas in Sion, that are flooded, but that water, the BMC is saying, will recede in the next few hours. When we talk about trains, Western Railway and Central Railway trains are running late, but they are running. The platforms and the tracks are not flooded like they were on the 29th of August. Also, when we talk about traffic snarls, we do not see a lot of traffic jams, maybe because people are taking precautionary measures and because schools and colleges have been shut as a precaution. So that could be the reason why we are not seeing a lot of traffic jams. When we talk about the airports, people at the airport, those passengers who are at the airport might have to wait a little longer for the flights to take off because there's delay in flights to take off because of low visibility. Apart from that, even though we have received more rainfall than we did on 29th of August, because all the authorities, the traffic police, Mumbai police and the BMC is on high alert, the city is still functioning, the city is still moving at a slow pace, but still moving. Ishwara Paliwal for Mirror Now.
And this is what Deputy Municipal Commissioner Sudhir Naik had to say.
We haven't received any warning for the cyclone from Indian Meteorological Department, and the whatever weather forecast we have received at 1:30 is intermittent rain in the city and suburbs. So citizens should not pay attention to these rumors of cyclone and rumors regarding the cut off electricity supply. But this kind of a scenario, when created in the other city of this country, there is a lot of inconvenience. We are there for the citizen. We are putting our best foot forward. 29-8, we had about 30,000 employees were in the field, despite being Ganesh Chaturthi festival. And today, 35,000 employees on the field. Our employees were working up to 1 a.m. yesterday night. And you must have seen in the morning, the city was running properly. There were no flooding. Even Hindamata, only we had a flooding for few hours yesterday, and for a very long time on 29th 8. But which has been barring that, there was no flooding in Hindamata this year also, and last 2 years also.
Well, that's all we have for now. But do stay with Mirror now for more news and updates.